John Challis lived life. Every day for 2 years fighting terminal cancer, John Challis lived life to the fullest. He never asked why, he knew why. God had a plan.
My reason is he thinks I'm strong enough to handle it, so he's using me to spread his message, to make the best out of things in life.
The world was introduced to John Challis only a few short months ago, his inspiring story touching millions of people. It was a story of courage, of belief. It was a story of life.
Courage and belief equals life. It's become my little theme.
John proved his point this past spring. He'd quit baseball after becoming afraid of the ball. Determined to overcome his fears, he asked his Freedom High School baseball coach if he could play, hoping to feel the rush of getting a hit just one more time.
I don't care what the score is. I don't care what the situation is. This kid's gonna play.
And he did. Wearing a flak jacket, 18-year-old, 93-pound John Challis stepped into the batter's box against Aliquippa.
First pitch, fastball, right down the middle. I swing, I crack it right between second and first and makes its way to the outfield. I get about 10 steps in the bag and I'm screaming, I did it, I did it.
He just wanted to prove. He just wanted to prove that he could do it. Not prove to himself, not at that point, not to his teammates, but to John Challis.
John was asked to spread his positive message of hope. As honorary manager of the Pirates for a day, John spoke to the team before they faced the Yankees. Many would assume that 18-year-old John would be inspired by professional athletes. Instead, it was the other way around.
We gave a great talk to our players about it being a game and living for each day. And don't worry about tomorrow, because you never know what tomorrow is going to bring.
You know, you hear it from coaches, but to hear it from somebody that's been through what he has, and as young as he is, you know, it means the world to us.
I was looking in these players' eyes, and they were listening. They weren't just listening to some 18-year-old kid, but they were listening to what he was saying. That was good. I mean, that made me feel good to hear my son speak the way he did.
John met Derek Jeter that day. Yankee slugger Alex Rodriguez was so captivated with John, he flew him to New York so the two could spend time together. He met Mario Lemieux, Ben Roethlisberger, and scores of other famous people, and he continued to inspire those who knew him best, his classmates, his teammates, and his family.
I'm strong enough to do that. But I couldn't have lived the rest of my life knowing cancer got the best of me.
My brother, John Challis. He taught me to live today. Don't worry about tomorrow.